Hi students, very good morning. I hope that you are following the videos perfectly, right? Now let us go for the energy of an electron. Okay, energy. See, total energy we know in the physics, that is nothing but the summation of potential energy plus kinetic energy. How you will be getting potential energy? Potential energy is nothing but the energy possessed by a body by virtue of its position, right? So here you are having a number of protons Z and charge of proton. Each proton here, electron, it is having some charge and they are separated by a distance r. So that is ze, this one into r, sorry, into minus e by r. So it will be equal to minus ze square by r. This is the potential energy. Clear, students? Potential energy is nothing but minus ze square by r. This is due to the, by virtue of its position, the energy, right? Kinetic energy, it is represented as half mv square. Clear? And while deriving the radius, we have come across that mv square is equal to ze square by r. Okay. In the previous lecture itself, I have shown that mv square will be equal to ze square by r. So that you place this ze square by r in place of mv square. So that you will be getting half in place of mv square, that is ze square by r. So we know that total energy is equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy. Potential energy we have got minus ze square by r. And kinetic energy you have got Z square by 2R. So total energy will be equal to minus Z square by 2R. This is the condition, students. Total energy value is this one. Potential energy value is this one. Kinetic energy value is this one. So if they ask sometimes the ratio between the total energy, potential energy, kinetic energy. So total energy ratio is to potential energy ratio is to kinetic energy. That is minus Z square by 2R minus Z square by R. Z square by 2R. If you calculate, you will be getting minus half is to minus 1 is to half. So that if you get the proportionality, you will be getting minus 1 is to minus 2 is to 1. So this is the relation between total energy, potential energy and kinetic energy. They may ask the relation between these two, or they may ask the relation between these two. They may ask the relation between these two, or they may ask between these three things. So this is the way. One is total energy, one is potential energy, one is kinetic energy. So this is the ratio. Right? There is one more way in terms of deriving in terms of physics. Okay. Nothing, don't bother about that. Not important for us this. We are concerned only with this content. Right, students? Right. We know that potential energy is equal to minus Z square by R. That is what we have learnt. Okay. We have derived also. Right. We know the value of R. What is the value of R? N square H square by 4 pi Z E square. Okay, if you substitute the value of R, the radius value here, R value is N square H square by 4 pi square, you will be getting Z E square, right? So that you will be getting 4 pi Z E square, 4 pi square, right? Students, that one, correct it. Minus Z E square, you will be getting, so potential energy is equal to minus 4 pi. So just I made a correction. So that is minus 4 pi square Z square e power 4 into M by N square H square. If you calculate the potential energy, by keeping the constant values, variable values are Z square and N square. Potential value, potential energy value will be equal to minus 13.6, okay, into 2 Z square by N square into electron volts. That is, in terms of electron volts, you will be getting, this is the value. Okay, kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. You know that is equal to Z square by 2R. And you know the value of R here. R value is N square H square by 4 pi square Z E square M, that goes into the numerator. So that you will be getting the kinetic energy. That is 4 pi square Z square E power 4 into M by 2 N square H square. Right? So that the kinetic energy value is 13.6 into Z square by N square. This is the value of kinetic energy as well as the potential energy. So this is the value of potential energy. 2 into 13.6 in terms of minus value Z square by N square electron volts. Kinetic energy is 4 pi square Z square e power 4 into M by 2 N square H square. You will be getting, if you guys substitute the values, you will be getting 13.6 into Z square by N square in terms of electron volts. Right? We know that total energy is equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy. So the total energy value will be equal to minus 2 pi square Z square M e power 4 by N square H square. If you substitute all the values and if you calculate, you will be getting minus 13.6 Z square by N square electron volts. Please be clear with this. Energy is directly proportional to Z square by N square. Okay. If you go for radius. Radius is what you will be getting radius. That is N square by Z you will be getting. Right. Okay. This is with respect to energy. This everything with respect to physics. Okay, let us take one example. Find the total energy of an electron in the nth shell of an hydrogen atom. Suppose if I ask the total energy in the first orbit. Okay, total energy. So what is the formula? This is the thing what we have got, minus 13.6 z square by n square electron volts. That is what it has been represented. He is asking for hydrogen atom. So z is equal to 1. For first orbit, n is equal to 1. So it is minus 13.6, z is equal to 1, n is equal to 1. So you will be getting minus 13.6 electron volts for the first orbit. If you go for the second orbit, so it is minus 13.6 into second orbit. Z is 1 itself. So it is 1 square by 2 square. Second orbit, right? So you will be getting minus 13.6 by 4. It is equal to minus 3.4 electron volts. Total energy in the third orbit, it is minus 13.6 into 1 square by 3 square, that is minus 13.6 by 9, it is minus 1.51 electron volts. Total energy in the fourth orbit, so minus 13.6 into 1 square by 4 square, that is equal to minus 13.6 by 16, it is equal to minus 0.85 electron volts. Please remember these values, students. Okay, if you are able to calculate, it's okay. You should remember at least 4 energy levels. Okay, first orbit energy. So these are the fixed energy. So we have learned that Bohr postulate has said the energy associated with the each and every orbit. So the first orbit is associated with the energy of minus 13.6 electron volts. Second orbit is minus 3.4. Third orbit is minus 1.1. Fourth orbit is minus 0.85 electron volts. So what is happening to the energy? If you go from the first orbit to the last orbit, the energy is going on increasing. See, this is in minus values. So 3.4 is greater than minus 13.6. Minus 3.4 is greater than minus 13.6, right? So as you move away from the nucleus, the energy of an orbit is going on increasing. So this is the first energy orbit, second energy orbit energy, third orbit, fourth orbit. Right, if you see the difference in energy, what is the difference between these two? We will be counting it as E2 minus E1, right? So delta E will be equal to E2 minus E1. E2 is equal to minus 3.4 minus of minus E1. What is that? 10.2. So the difference between E2 minus E1, it is 10.2 electron volts. Okay, means if you provide 10.2 electron volts, the electron will jump from E1 to E2. Right? If you provide something like 9.2 electron volts for the electron present in the first orbit, it will not jump into this orbit. Okay, if you want, see, electron will not absorb all the energy. Okay, the energy is constant. For an electron whichever that is present in orbit, the electron absorbs only the energy when it is a fixed one. So if you provide electron for this one, whenever it is present in the first orbit, it will not jump to second orbit immediately. If you provide only 10.2 electron volts, it jumps. Suppose if you provide 9.2, it will not jump to here. It will not absorb that type of energy. It will absorb only that energy which is eligible to sit in the next orbit. From here to here also. Same, if you take the difference, that will be the condition. And in the same way, it absorbs or emits the energy only that is suitable for the next energy level. Okay, that is what the sixth point of Bohr's orbit. Right, so that is what I have said. See, electron can gain or lose energy which are equal in difference between two energy levels. So from one electron from one orbit to another orbit, if you want to come, it absorbs only that difference in that two energy levels. Right, that's why the energy is quantized. So if the electron absorbs the energy, or if it gains, it is called as, if the electron absorbs energy and it gets shifted to the other energy level, that is called as excitation. Suppose electron is moving from first orbit to second orbit, it is called as excitation. Second to third, it is excitation. Third to fourth, excitation. First to fourth, excitation. First to third, excitation, right? From higher orbit, if it goes into the lower orbit, then it is called as de-excitation, means it is losing the excitation capacity. So from higher orbit to the lower orbit, if the electron jumps, that is called as de-excitation. If it jumps from lower orbit to the higher orbit, it is called as excitation. Right? Minimum energy is present in the first shell. Okay, you know that if you are going away, the energy goes on increasing. So which will be having the less amount of energy? The first orbit will be having the less amount of energy. So as the electron moves away from the nucleus, the energy of the electron increases. Suppose if you take n is equal to infinity. Okay, you don't know where it is going to jump. Infinity orbit you are taking. Then the total energy will be equal to 0. That's what we will be calling it as ionization potential. Okay, the total energy is 0 if the electron jumps from nth orbit to the infinity distance. Okay, if you want the difference, suppose E2 will be equal to delta E is equal to E2 minus E1, delta E is equal to E3 minus E1. Okay, if you want to check the difference in the energy levels. Okay, students. See, whatever I have said here, it is called as ionization potential. What is mean by ionization potential? The amount of energy required to remove an electron from the outermost orbit of an neutral gaseous atom. It is called as ionization potential, right? So what the fault you are seeing is, if you take the atomic spectra, suppose if you are taking a container, the container is entirely filled with hydrogen gas and you are passing a white light into that. So generally on the screen, you are placing a screen here. You are taking a container with hydrogen gas molecules and you are passing a white light onto the container. On the other side of the container, you are placing a screen. Okay, so that it recognizes the color. White light passes through this container, and only if you see some light here, generally you should be having VBGR colors, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, like that. Some colors have been absent here. Suppose if I assume that B is absent. Okay, then due to the absence of B, there will be a production of spectra that is called as line spectra or discrete spectrum. We'll be learning with respect to the spectra again. Okay, some will be missing. Why these are getting missing? Okay, when you are passing white light onto the container containing hydrogen molecules, some with light, okay, among the VBGR is getting missed on the screen. Why these are getting missed on the screen? Means that is what he said, that hydrogen molecules will absorb some frequency of light so that the electron jumps into the or it moves away from the atom. Again, I am repeating, hydrogen atom or hydrogen molecule, whatever that is present here, it absorbs the white light of certain frequency. It absorbs that frequency of energy so that the electron jumps into the next orbit. Okay, so that particular amount of light is getting mixed, and the remaining light, whichever does not match to the frequency of excitation or de-excitation of the electron in the hydrogen atom, that will not be absorbed, so that falls directly on the screen. Whichever the light among the white light is nothing but the mixture of all the colors, right? Visible light, that will be absorbed. One light will be absorbed, and the whichever not absorbed, that will be present on the screen. Whichever it is absorbed, that will be absent on the screen. This is because the light which has been absorbed is used for the excitation of one electron or to the another level. That is what I have said regarding this spectrum. We'll be learning in detail in the next class. Okay, students, this is what for today. Have a nice day. Bye bye.